Hi everyone, I'm Ibrahim Ulukaya from YouTube API Developer Relations team, and today we are going to talk about a new API and set of functionalities called YouTube Live Streaming API. Joining me today, Satyajeet Salgar, who is the product manager of YouTube Live and Sports, and Derek Tan, who is the tech lead for the Live Streaming API. Thanks so much for joining me today, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, bro.
So before going any further, Satyajeet, please tell us about the new YouTube Live Streaming platform.
Sure, we're really excited about the live platform that we built at YouTube and the kind of experiences it's enabled. Over the last few months, we've seen an incredible number of events from our content partners. Everything from the Red Bull Straight Off Jump, which had over 8 million concurrent viewers, to the election of the Pope, to the last US presidential elections, and just a number of esports tournaments, gaming events, news events, and sports events. The live engineering team at YouTube has done an incredible job with our platform. We have incredible stream quality, and features like transcoding in the cloud. So you only need to send us one stream, and we transcode it to all the different device formats and resolutions required. Things like adaptive bitrate, so we figure out the right stream quality to send to the user based on their bandwidth. DVR, so users can skip back and forth. And we make it really easy to do things like insert slates, insert ad cue points. We're really excited about the kind of experiences this platform will enable for our YouTube creators.
Okay, great. Derek, maybe after this talk, the main question in everyone's mind, what's the live streaming API? What are the functionalities coming with this API?
Yeah, the YouTube live streaming API is a set of API methods that allow you to create, update, and manage your live events. It currently consists of three major APIs, live broadcast, live stream, and live cue points. Live broadcast and live stream are built upon the YouTube data API. Live cue point is built upon the YouTube partner API. And by using this free API, you are able to schedule a live event, configure the stream, test, start, stop the live event, enable DVR, enable recording, and monetize it by adding the ad cue point.
Okay. In addition to these core features, actually, what is the target developer audience for this API?
Sure. YouTube live streaming is enabled for a set of YouTube content partners. We expect the live API to make it much easier for them to create and manage their own events. In addition, we expect some of the most interesting uses of this API to come from developers that are building tools and apps for these partners, either new products or integrating it into existing products. I believe you're going to demo one such product later today.
Yeah, that would be great, actually. Actually, we just talked about the core features. And from the developer's documents, I just saw that actually this API interacts with the data API and the content partner API. Derek, can you explain a little bit about this interaction and the philosophy behind it?
Yeah, sure. One philosophy of the new API is to make it very easy to understand and simple to use. In the old API, we duplicate some functionality with the data API and YouTube API. In the new design, we just make it very specific to the live API and move the regular video management functionality to data API and partner API. For example, if you want to monetize your stream, monetize your video, you just call the partner API to claim the video content and then call the live coupon API to add it, add coupon in real time. And another example is that if you want to get the regular video metadata, for example, how many users like your video, just call the data API. And obviously, if you want to get the broadcast metadata, for example, the life cycle status of broadcast, stream status, just call the live API. And if you see the live API spec, you should see that the new API request and response is much shorter and clearer.
Well, thanks, Eric, for clearing this up. And I just also want to say at this point that actually the live streaming API, the libraries actually comes under the data API. And maybe if you are wondering where is the live streaming API in your dev console, once you enable the data API, the live streaming capabilities will be also be enabled. Being said that, actually, are there any new scopes introduced with this new API, or are they using the same OAuth 2 scopes that the YouTube data API is using?
Yes. Live broadcast and live stream API are based on the YouTube data API, so they share the same OAuth 2 scope, which are YouTube Doc Read-Only and YouTube. Live coupon API is a part of the partner API. It uses YouTube partner as OAuth 2 scope.
Okay, I think that's great. Thanks for joining me, guys. And I think that's a great time to start seeing some demos and a few examples from our early integrators. So maybe a good example to start is the create broadcast example I created, which actually does the OAuth2 authorization, then creates a broadcast, and then creates a stream, and then binds them together so that you have like you have a ready stream, you have a ready scheduled broadcast that you can just stream. Let's go over the example. So for this example, we use the OAuth2 authorization as I described, going through the Google authorization code flow. And once the user actually authorizes us to use their credentials, then what we do is we create our YouTube object and create a broadcast with a title, with a scheduled start time, scheduled end time, and setting its private status to private. We first create an insert request, execute the request, get a response as a broadcast object. So we just like print out all the broadcast object's properties, and then we create a stream in a similar way. We get the title, we set the broadcast title, then we set the CDN format, content distribution format is 1080p, and we set the ingestion type as RTMP. Then we create an insert request, but with the execution of the insert request, we get a response as a stream, and we just print out that one. And then we create a bind request, and we actually execute the bind request, and now we are ready to, then we'll be ready to go. So let's actually do this and see how it works. So we create a broadcast, let's say, we create the broadcast title as broadcast one. We get the broadcast title, start time, end time. Let's create a stream two. We get the stream address. And there's one thing I actually added into the example, that we also return the ingestion address, which you will be using it when you are streaming. So once you create the stream, you actually get an ingestion address, and you will put into your actual streamer. And let's see in the actually in our size, when we refresh our own size, you see the broadcast is already created. And once we see in the channel settings, we also check the streams. And in streams, we also see that our stream is already created. I think it's a good time. We can just like check all the other examples.
Our first example is from Elgato Game Capture HD.
With Elgato Game Capture HD, you can record your PlayStation and Xbox gameplay to a Mac or PC and share your clips with your friends. Now YouTube has made it really easy to live stream your gameplay. Go live with the click of a button.
Let's see another example from Capella Systems Cambria Live.
Cambria Live is an enterprise level software that encodes live broadcasters in real time and uploads them to popular streaming servers. For YouTube Live channel, you can add account from account manager, enter email and password registered with YouTube Live channel. Please note that you must be certified contents partner in order to stream to YouTube Live channel. Once you enter email and password, YouTube Live account is added in account manager. You can then select YouTube from target, and it will bring up all channels registered from your account. Once specified channel, it automatically imports suggested presets by YouTube for optimal video quality. You can simply start streaming all the streams by clicking on Start Streaming. Even after it started streaming, you can change video quality by clicking on Show Advanced Settings. You can modify frame size, frame rate, video aspect ratio, and also bit rate. You can also preview streaming preview page by clicking streaming preview from the encode settings, allowing you to verify the stream looks okay. Cambria Live comes with a very powerful edit tool called Cambria Live Edit. When used with our file-based transcoding software called Cambria File Convert, user can create highlight clips on the fly during a live event by simply setting in and out points within the Cambria Live Edit timeline. This edit point data then transfers to Cambria File Convert, which can generate highlight clips in multiple video formats and also upload the encoded files to FTP site or YouTube VOD channel. You can seek in and out points at any point of the live event and create multiple highlight clips without having any downtime. There is also an option to immediately re-import the segment back to live without sending it to Cambria File Convert. So while you're doing continuous streaming, you can restream highlights without having any downtime. As you can see, Cambria Live is a very unique and powerful production tool that enables and enhances professional live streaming broadcast production. If you would like to know more about Cambria Live, please visit our website at www.capellasystems.net.
Well, that was the demos, and I think it's a great API. And thanks for joining me guys today for this
help. Thanks for having us.
Now, I think you guys are really excited, and we hope like you enjoy this API and start using it right away. Have a great day.